Size 26 Rula, her sister Tracy, and friends Jenna and Bunny are hoping today will be the day she finds a dress.
I think you have to stay classy. And I think...
No, I'd trash it all the way.
So far, dress shopping for her wedding to Jack in 6 months' time has been an ordeal.
If I don't find a dress today, I'm not sure what my next avenue would be. Keep putting myself through the uncomfortableness of getting undressed and stuff like that, and coming out and not finding a dress would, I think it would like break me a little bit.
So, have you been dress shopping?
Yeah, I've been to a couple of stores.
Uh-huh.
One I left in tears, and on the same day, one I left with a dress.
Oh.
Well, I paid a deposit for a dress.
Oh, right. So what happens if you find one today, then?
I've already told them that I'm not having that dress.
Ah.
OK.
So you've lost your deposit, then?
Yeah, £700.
Ooh.
That's a quite a big amount of money.
Because of the bad experience beforehand, I went to that shop on the same day and felt like I needed to get a dress. I panic a little bit, so the impulsiveness is not great.
I've got to, like, get undressed in front of someone other than Jack.
You'll be all right. It's not going to be like that other shop you went to.
I think the thing is with Rula, she's dipped her toe in the pool and, you know, she's withdrawn because it's too scary. So we need to absolutely nail this today.
I have the perfect dress.
Right.
The perfect dress. Arrived this morning, so it's not out, it's not been stained.
OK.
And I just think that we've just got to make up for the fact that she had a crap experience and then she's bought a disaster dress.
Mm-hmm.
I hate fitting rooms. And I think that's why my whole demeanour changed just a bit. Cos just the fact that I'd had to get undressed. To me, they are looking and to me, they are judging. I just want to make the right decision, because we've already had one disaster.
Yeah.
And lost that.
This is about more than the dress, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
I can see right now that you are on the verge of a real meltdown, and I'm trying to take this away from you.
I'm even more meltdowning now, because there's a spider in the room.
Oh, she don't like spiders!
I literally do have a meltdown about spiders. I hate it. I hate spiders.
Right, Joe, I need you to come get rid of this spider.
I have to back away a bit.
Where you need back away. Good
oh, my
Lord.
Good God.
I've never seen a bride so petrified.
Anyone would think that that is like a tarantula. I can't even see it properly without my glasses. Oh. Hello, little friend.
Oh. Has she gone with it?
Yes, yeah, she's gone with it. OK, you can come off the wall now, Rula.
So, are we ready, ladies?
Yeah.
You have to close your eyes as well, Rula.
Rula's experiences previously, I would say, has completely knocked her confidence.
She lacks in confidence anyway, though, doesn't she?
She does, she's... but I think this has knocked her even more, because she's my rock, and seeing her upset upsets me. So it does upset me quite a bit to see her sad.
Right. All of you can open your eyes.
Oh, my God, it's amazing. Oh, God. My God.
I love
That's
it.
That's amazing. Oh.
Scott, you look beautiful.
Oh, my God, look at that waist. Have a waist. I feel incredible. I feel like it's the best I've ever looked in a dress. I saw the bride that I wanted to be. When I opened my eyes, it was just like, wow.
To see her happy and, you know, see that confidence
just grow
is it's brilliant.
It's amazing.
Oh, God, I'm such an ugly cry. This is what I'm going to walk down the aisle in. I just felt amazing.
Do you feel like you need to try on another one for a comparison?
No.
I didn't even need you to finish that sentence.
Oh, give me five.
Well, give
me
five.
Oh, you look amazing.
Oh, thank delight.
Thank you.
Delight.
Oh, my God. On the morning of the wedding, I'm probably going to be quite anxious. Probably a little bit stressy.
I think that on the day, Rula will need encouraging to really believe. When we send her down the aisle, we want her to feel absolutely amazing.
The big day has finally arrived for Rula and Jack.
How's that looking? All right?
And although there isn't a spider in sight, the bride is finding other things to panic about.
Everyone will be looking at me. I think that's the most scariest part. I don't want to cry.
If ever a bride needed Jo and Al to bring the calm, it's this one.
As a bride, you are undoubtedly centre of attention. Some of our brides don't want that.
If it's anything to go by when she came into the boutique to choose her dress, then today times 100.
Yeah.
Hello, hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm all right.
You look a bit nervous. You're like, oh, I'm all right.
Yeah, I am very nervous.
What are you nervous of, Rula? Is there anything we can help you with?
Is it the falling over thing?
No, it's the fat thing.
She's terrified. She is stuck to the spot.
She's got herself as far into the smallest corner of the room that she can. I think she's hoping she's going to be able to disappear through the wall.
I need to put my boobs in my dress.
You need to do that.
Yeah, you can do.
It's fine.
But once we're ready to actually tighten up, at the moment, we're just feeding it through.
Am I in? Please tell me it's.
What are you talking about? Are you in?
You're in.
I have a veil as well. I don't know if I need the veil.
Yes, you do.
Really?
Rula, panic not.
She constantly picks holes in herself, and it could be the dress, it could be the garter, it could be the straps. It doesn't matter what it is. She's picking holes in everything.
Is Bunny around?
Do you want me to get Bunny?
Yeah.
All right, look, why are you panicking? Why are you panicking?
I don't know, I just need Bunny for a bit.
All right.
Just for
we'll get Bunny. I'll get Bunny.
This has been building up for 2 years, and all of a sudden we're down to this moment.
Oh, that's just...
Come here. Oh, you're
fine.
You look gorgeous.
I just needed to see you, I think.
We need to put a stop to this right now. She's marrying the man of her dreams, and this, at the moment, is making it not a fairy tale wedding, but more of a nightmare wedding. What do you see?
Well, I see me.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I look all right.
You are?
No, I do look pretty.
We're so proud of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the arrival of the bridal party.
At the end of the day, it's all about us. And I know she's just going to look perfect.
As I was walking down the aisle, I think my sister was saying breathe. So I was listening to her. So I was breathing. I was like, I just got to get to Jack. Just got to get to Jack.
I promise to love you and honour you in joy and sorrow.
Day by day, I promise to love you in joy and sorrow. I think that's what I just needed, and the entire day, it was just to see him, because, you know, he's my soulmate.
And you're the most amazing person in the whole world. You just look gorgeous, stunning. I am one lucky man.
For a split moment, I didn't think Rula was going in that room at all.
But the moment she saw Jack and he saw her, there was that connection, and she was fine.
It was beautiful.